I'm Vanessa Joy, and here's how to shoot a nighttime portrait. So you're getting ready to shoot a nighttime portrait. How do you even begin? Well, I personally like shooting during that twilight time where the sun is just going down and you have that nice blue glow in the sky. It's a gorgeous time of night and just adds to the depth of the photograph when you have a blue glowing background versus a completely dark one. There's a few things that you're going to need in order to photograph a nighttime scene with a subject properly. For how we're going to shoot this, you're going to use a tripod. Now, to be honest, I actually don't even bring a tripod on the wedding day. I bring a platypod, which those are pretty cool because they're light. I tend to not bring a tripod because I don't typically use it. But for this shoot right here, we were experimenting with the Canon 1D X Mark III. You can check out that video. And I wanted to do a little bit more of a slower exposure. I had ideas. So I do have a tripod here, but it's actually not completely necessary. You just adjust your settings to compensate for the fact that you're not gonna go super low on your shutter speed. Obviously, you need your camera, and then I do suggest that you have two different off-camera flashes. I have two Profoto B10s. One of them is going to be used to backlight your subject, and the other one is going to be used to light your subject's face. The one lighting your subject's face, ideally you have some kind of modifier on it, just softening it, or maybe even directing it. I had an off-camera flash beauty dish, a portable beauty dish from Profoto, on the light that was lighting her face, and then on the backlight, I either shoot it raw or I shoot it with a grid. The grid really helps to direct the light without overexposing the ground. You don't want the ground to be super overexposed and blowing out because then the viewer's attention just goes straight to the ground instead of to your subject's face. Before we jump into this, make sure that you download my free posing inspiration guide. We could all use some inspiration. Get that in the link below with lots of ideas on how to pose groups and individuals. Getting your shot set up at first, don't worry about your lights. Just set your exposure for the background. Make sure that it's good as if you were just photographing a night scene. You don't have to go 2 stops darker. I know people tell you to do that, but light it how you want it. Maybe you want to go 2 stops brighter. I don't know. Do what you want to do. It's your photo. Make your photo look how you would want it to. I decided that I wanted to see more blue in the sky, and then I also wanted to see those lights in the castle. So I set my exposure accordingly. The other thing you want to do, or I like to do when I'm photographing a night scene, is to blue down the entire shot. So if I cool down my white balance, the whole shot, specifically the sky, gets a nice, rich, deep blue. Now we have to fix that for our subject in a minute, and I'll let you know how. After you have your exposure set for the background and your white balance down, if you choose to do that, now it's time to set up your subject and set up your lights. Place your subject where you would want them in the frame. Place one light behind them, probably about 6 feet or so, and pointed more up at their heads rather than just down. Again, we don't really want it hitting the ground, and sometimes even with a grid, it still will, just depending on how far away your light is from the subject and how condensed your grid is. The other light, the light that's going to illuminate their faces, I tend to like to put at a 90 to 45 degree angle from my subject. It's nighttime. I want it to look dramatic. I want to have a shadow side, so I'm going to make sure that the light is a little heavier of an angle in relation to my subject so I can get that look. I start off by using TTL. I turn on my lights, set my transmitter to TTL, and take a picture. TTL is just auto for your light. It's going to determine how much power, how much brightness should be coming out of the flashes based on the circumstances and the settings and a whole bunch of math that it figures out for you. Is it perfect every time? No, but it's pretty darn close and a really fast way to get an about power setting from your lights. From there, just adjust your lights up or down if you want them brighter or darker. Guys, they're lights. There are two functions. You can either make them brighter or you can make them darker. Granted, you can point them in different directions, but as far as the power setting, it's up or down. What do you want it to be? Now, at this point, if you have blued down your white balance, your subject is probably looking like a Smurf right around now. So, what do we do to fix this? If you think of a color wheel and you picture that in your head, you have some colors on one side and then opposite colors or complementary colors on the other side. The cool thing about the opposite sides of the color wheel is when you combine those colors, let's say blue with yellow, or wherever this is on the screen here, blue and yellow, it creates white. The colors will cancel each other out so you get a pure white light. And that's how you're going to desmurfify your subject. Take an orange gel, a CTO, color temperature orange gel, and put it on the light that is lighting their face. It's your choice whether you want the light behind them to have the gel on it as well, or maybe you like the bluish kind of light that will end up coming from it. You may have to mess around with how many gels or how dark saturated of those CTO gels that you're gonna put on the flash. Maybe it's a half, maybe it's a full, maybe it's two fulls, but it's all in relation to how much you've blued down your white balance. So you could always just choose to put a half a CTO gel on it and then adjust your white balance so that your subject's skin tone is where you want it to be. From there, take a few shots, play and have fun. I certainly did on this shoot. We actually brought canned fog and sprayed it all around just to give the ground a little bit more of a mist, add a little something extra to the shoot. It was fun. I do have a link down below to that canned fog. It's a lot of fun. Fair warning, by the way, your finger gets a little tired holding it down, and if you let that fog touch your finger, it will freeze it like to death. So just be careful. Play safely, kids. I hope you've been able to learn how to take a nighttime portrait. It might take a few times. Guys, you might end up watching this video a few times or maybe having it as you go through step by step. There's gonna be trial and error. Don't worry, don't panic, you will get it. Make sure you hit subscribe for more videos like this one here on my YouTube channel. Bye.